please welcome to Moments with Bia, where we initiate change with purpose. Today I want to talk to you about three actions you can take to gain back control over the emotional overwhelm due to infertility. Before we do that, I want to encourage you to subscribe so that you can get notified every time I post a new video, which is every Wednesday. Action number one, limit or eliminate your alone time. And here's why. Every time you have some spare time or every time you have a me time, your mind starts wandering off and it sort of tends to go for the areas of your life where you feel like things aren't exactly the way you want them to, where you feel like there needs to be some kind of a fixing of some sort or certain circumstances that aren't necessarily the way you want them to at the moment. So your mind goes straight for those areas and starts dwelling and dwelling and dwelling. And what happens is you start thought after thought after thought, and the next thing you know, you're down this rabbit hole that is leading you nowhere. So you want to limit or eliminate that time alone. What do you do? How do you do that? What I did, or what helped me a lot when I was going through infertility, and I hope that this will help you as well, is go to a coffee shop, go to the gym, call a friend, call a family member that you haven't talked to in a while, catch up with them, talk to them. Anything that you can do to distract your mind from going straight to your pain point. What happens is, even if you go to the coffee shop, you would be going there by yourself, but there's so much happening in a public place like that, that your mind won't necessarily be able to sit there and just dwell on your pain, because there will be too many things, too many distractions happening at the same time, and you're going to be, observing other people, or maybe you'll find someone that you will talk to. You will constantly be distracted. Action number two is to let yourself have an emotional meltdown. And this will probably sound counterintuitive, because I just told you that what you don't want to do is you don't want to let your mind dwell on your infertility negative thoughts, or your negative thoughts related to infertility. And now I'm telling you to sort of do just that. But this is very important. And here's why. When you go through an emotional meltdown, hopefully not at the coffee shop, hopefully in your home, but when you go through an emotional meltdown, when you let yourself go through it, what you're doing is you're freeing your mind from all the negative thoughts or negative feelings, emotions that you have around the particular topic. And since here we're talking about infertility, that would be around the topic of infertility. You are basically letting yourself get all those emotions out, get an emotional release, and then afterwards you feel better. But in order to feel better longer, in order to really get the most out of what I call a constructive emotional meltdown, there's a second part to that. Once you go through that emotional meltdown, once you cry it out, and however way you go through an emotional meltdown, write it down. Get a piece of paper or a journal or a notebook, whatever, write it down. And the reason for that is because when you write something down, it is really out of your mind, and it is out on paper, and you can either let it go, or you can basically feed it back to your mind if you keep going back and looking at it. So there's a theory that if you want to achieve your goals, you basically write them down. And so what you're doing is, in order to realize your goals by writing them down, you're getting them off your mind on a piece of paper, and that is kind of getting you on your way to actually realizing them. But the realization part of that comes when you actually refer back to those goals. So you write them down, and then the suggested next step is to look at them on a regular basis. So you're writing them down, getting them out of your mind onto a paper, and then you're feeding your mind back with them by referring to them every day. What you're doing with your negative emotions, with your negative thoughts, you're writing them down and then you're letting them go. You're not referring back to them. You're not feeding your mind back. You're just releasing that energy, and you're just relieving yourself from all that negativity. You're putting it on a piece of paper and you're letting it go. You don't need to refer to it. This isn't something that you're going to be showing to other people. This is just for you. So you really, you write anything down and then you let it go. You don't look at it ever again if you don't want to. And so that's what really helped me when I was going through infertility. But it takes a while to get to that point where you can actually go through an emotional meltdown and then write about it. Because as I was talking to a woman who's going through infertility right now, and I suggested this, she said that it sounded like something that would be helpful, but she couldn't get herself to do that. She just wasn't ready to go through an emotional, after going through an emotional meltdown, to sit down and go through it again by writing it down. She felt like she would be kind of reliving her emotional meltdown. But this is very important. Again, if you can get yourself to do this, it is very helpful. And what happens after a while, after you do it maybe a couple of times or a few times, the idea is, and personal experience dictates, that you're gonna need to go through those emotional meltdowns less and less and less and less, and you're gonna be able to gain control over your emotional well-being around infertility, which in essence will help you think more clearly around the topic, and think more clearly around also the topic of yourself and what you really want and how you really want to go about the topic of infertility. Action number three is to immediately stop researching anything on infertility. Not medical treatments, not any alternative medicine, not anything new that may come up, not even certain information or videos about other women who are going through infertility and they are filming themselves going through that and sharing what they're going through without an actual end next step or end productivity result associated with that particular piece of information. And here's why. When you watch those videos or when you read information like that, your mind temporarily feels better because you see that you're not the only person who's going through infertility. And that is great, because you're not. And this is a topic that does need to be talked about more, and parts of it addressed. So somebody sharing what they're going through is great, and it's good. And it's good in the sense that you know you're not the only one going through it. But the part where it isn't so productive for you and what you're going through is that if that piece of information is just a venting piece of information, then it's only giving you a temporary sense of, okay, I'm not alone, so that makes me feel better. But then there, what's next, right? So what do you do about it? So that's why you wanna limit or maybe like schedule a certain time when you can go and just do that, but then don't do it aside from that scheduled time, which means if you have some free time, you know, if you're waiting for something or you just find yourself, you know, you have your phone on you and you start searching about infertility, well, let me see, you know, what's going on, just in case maybe I run into something new, maybe something that I haven't tried before. So don't do that. Try to stop yourself from doing that. Try to do that within that scheduled time that you had, like, I don't know, maybe Thursday night for half an hour, I'm just gonna, you know, focus on looking up infertility stuff. Stick to that. Don't do it at any other time. So what do you do? What do you do if, you know, if I'm telling you not to get exposed and not to go after information on infertility constantly, what do you do? What is very helpful and something that I didn't have when I was going through infertility, and something that there were very limited resources on when I was going through infertility, and I think that now there's a little bit more of, is joining a support group. But joining a true support, either online or offline, group where you can go and you, and people are truly supportive. So it's not what I call a venting platform. So you have to be careful, because there are a few groups you can join out there where it's very helpful to go and people share some really good advice, and women also share things that you may not have heard of, or certain resources. So join those groups, but make sure that they're not just vending platforms where people just go and they pour their heart out and talk about how painful it is to go through infertility emotionally, but they also suggest certain things that you can try, you know, like give you a little bit of an advice. So those are the three actions I suggest you start in order to regain your emotional well-being, regain control over your emotional well-being around infertility. I hope that you try them. I hope that you find them helpful. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up and let me know below in the comments, what was the one thing, one takeaway for you from this video, or if there's a certain topic that you want me to cover in an upcoming video, please let me know below in the comments. I read every comment and I post a video every Wednesday. So until then, remember to initiate change with purpose, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao!